Take 5. Defining hope. It had been a while since my last tape. My mind was no longer aware of my bodily sensations. The new world was real. There was nothing left. How could there be? And what did it even mean to me? Nothing. So why was I recording these tapes? I was hopeless. Hopeless. I was back to where I started at the concrete complex. Walking at the feet of these enormous buildings. They were just there, demonstrating a vacuum of color, a vacuum of life. Was I dead? Apparently not, but I was not fully alive either. The future did not turn out the way I thought it would. But what did I expect, really? I'd been searching for beauty because I noticed its absence. But what about motivation? Passion? Love? Feeling of futility, I sat down and distractedly examined the dusty ground. My hands turned white and had dried out from all the dust, but I didn't notice it. My mind was elsewhere contemplating these thoughts when a movement summoned me back. It was her, my mad magpie. She ambled silently around as the last time I saw her. I wondered if she'd found someone special. But I couldn't see any other magpies. I looked at my hands and saw the white dust. Tried to dust it off, it made me sneeze. My magpie gazed at me with a certain look, as if I had offended her with my disruptive sound, but she returned to her errands a few seconds later, minding her own business. Why would there be any birds in this shadowy landscape of trash, dust, and rubble? Why would she build a nest in this mess? But there she was, alone, but strong and free. Perhaps she wasn't even searching for a mate. She could clearly fend for herself. Thinking of this gave me a strange sensation of feeling good. So I watched her, silently. Sometimes she would come quite close to me and I could see all her black and white feathers very clearly, but it came as a great surprise to me when a beam of sunlight unexpectedly lightened up her feathers and a whole new bird was revealed from inside of her. She wasn't just black and white. The black turned out to be a whole range of colors. The most striking shades of green, blue, yellow, purple. How could I not have noticed all her colors? Without warning, I felt something from deep inside of me. There it was again. Something was beating. I'd forgotten that I had a heart pumping warm blood through my body. Once again, I'd seen beauty through the eyes of the magpie. A subtle beauty, but beauty nonetheless. Maybe my life could start again.